Introduction to geometry. From the main menu, let's hit Tap Geometry. The geometry on the ClassPad 400 allows you to use the stylus to make your constructions, also to manipulate your geometric figures. Let's take a look at some of the menu items. Here you can adjust the window by grabbing and moving around, zooming, zoom in, zoom out, adjust the window, or make a zoom window. Next, you've got some of your basic tools, points, segments, lines, rays, vectors, circles, semicircles, ellipses, or conic sections, function grapher, and basic geometric figures. These are regular figures. Next, we've got some construction tools or building tools. Triangles, isosceles triangles, equilateral triangles, trapezoids, etc. You can even do an n-gon. You decide how many sides and it'll draw it for you. Perpendicular, perpendicular bisector. This is a midpoint. Intersection, angle bisector, parallels, tangents, reflections, translations, rotations, dilations, and matrices. The next one is for setting up your grid, so you can put a grid in the background. You've got a couple of different options, including the dots, the grid itself, and finally back to the regular construction. Over arrow includes, this is a measurement tool which allows you to lock certain measurements in place. So let's go back. We also have a file to save and open. Edit, you can edit properties. You can animate. We'll take a look at that in the next video. Cut, paste, select, clear all. We can view. Different options for viewing. Whether or not the grid will be on or off. Drawing. Basic objects. Special polygons. Functions. Similar to the same thing we've got on the menu bar. Measurements of different kinds. Attached angles, etc. We can also do constructions. We'll look at constructions a little later on, and there's a couple of different places we can look at that. Let's do some of the basics. To draw a point, tap on the point, select where you want to place it, just tap on the screen. It automatically gets labeled for you. Let's do a segment. In this case, we would tap on a point, and then a second point. This one's based on A, so we use point from A, but you don't need to. Tap any two places, and it picks up where it left off. Let's draw a line. This is a continuous line that goes on forever. Line segment. We've done. Let's do array. Starting at G, going through H. A vector. Starting and ending points. A circle. Center and radius. An arc. It decides the arc based on the first placement of the radius and then the second placement. We're going to do some kind of conic. Three. There's 3 points. It creates your ellipse. Let's do one based on 3 points. The two foci and 1 point outside. Let's go ahead and clear off the screen. We'll go into Edit, Clear All, and tap OK. Let's see where we're at. Hyperbola. Parabola. Function. Here you just type in your function. We'll use, let's find our sine. Let's do a sine wave, do the sine of x. You can do any function you want. We'll tap OK. There's your sine wave. And finally, we're just going to go ahead and do any solid. Not a solid, but any geometric figure you want. This will connect the dots. Once you come back to one of the original dots that you start, one of the original points, it'll stop and start a new one. So once you get back to the original, there you have your polygon of any shape, any form. Let's go ahead and erase all that. So we'll clear that out. We'll say OK. Let's draw some basic geometric figures. What's nice about the ClassPad is it allows you to do this in one tap. So we'll select a triangle. We'll tap once, and there you have it. Or you could also tap the triangle, tap and hold, select an area, and then let go. So you decide where it is you want to draw. Tap and hold. We'll select the triangle. Tap and hold. Makes a construction box. This is where the triangle will be made. And it'll fit a triangle in there. If we want to do an isosceles triangle, all you got to do again, you could select your box or simply tap on the screen, highlight, tap on the screen. Let's edit and get rid of all that. Works the same for isosceles triangles. We'll just tap. Or trapezoids. The calculator will decide which shape will fit the best in that screen. So based on the dimensions of the screen we're currently in, it will fill the screen with whatever shape it is you want. Also notice you've got some tick marks here that are really nice for doing your constructions or your definitions. We'll do a few more. There's a square. And finally, let's do an N-gon. Let's do a six-sided N-gon centered right there. And there you have your six sides. Again, let's go ahead and clear all. I know I'm rushing through those. You can always watch this a little slower if you would like a little more detail. Let's see how you can manipulate different objects on the screen. Let's go ahead and start out with an isosceles triangle. And this time we'll decide what size we want. So we'll tap and hold, drag out. There you have it. Once you let go of the stylus, it'll go ahead and place your isosceles triangle. Again, notice the tick marks on the screen. To manipulate this, make sure you've got the arrow selected. This works a little bit differently than you would on a regular computer. You want to tap to select. Once that's highlighted, I've highlighted point C, tap and hold, and then drag, and it won't stop to draw until you actually drop it. Now when you drop it, this will stay an isosceles triangle, and everything gets rotated around so that it stays the original shape that you decided to construct. Again, let's move point A, select point A by tapping on A, and then releasing, tap and hold, move point A to its end point, and let it go. And then let's, one more time, let's try to move B. Tap on B and release. Hold on B, tap and hold, and then release. Let's go ahead and clear all. Let's do some basic instructions now. Let's construct a segment. We'll make a segment here. We'll call that AB. Let's come over here and do a perpendicular. So we'll go with a perpendicular. It's going to be a perpendicular bisector. Select that. Tap your perpendicular bisector, and there you have your perpendicular bisector. This time, let's build a perpendicular through a line. So let's make a segment. Segment AB. We'll also need a point, since we want to make a perpendicular through a point. So we're going to go ahead and construct that. We'll select the perpendicular through a point. We need to select a line and the point to be perpendicular through. And then go ahead and tap the tool, and there we have it. Again, once you've got the arrow selected, we'll tap on some white space, select point C, tap it, release, tap and hold, and let's move point C. You notice how it moves your perpendicular around the screen. You could also tap on B, tap and hold and move B, and watch how that changes. Let's go ahead and edit and clear all there. Let's do another construction here. We'll start with the segment. Midpoint. Select it. Select midpoint. There's midpoint C. Tap on some white space there. If you move point B, notice point C remains in the midpoint. We'll go ahead and clear that. What else do we have here? We've got point on an object. We want point of intersection of two line segments. So let's try a couple line segments here. You can do lines or rays. This time we're going to select the two line segments. We want the point of intersection. We go to our tool, intersection point, and there it is at point E. Clear all. What's next? Angle bisector. Let's construct an angle. We'll use two rays. Here's one. Second ray starts at A, goes through C. Grab our selection tool. Select the two sides of the angle. Open, angle bisector. Notice it gives us a couple of angle bisectors here. It actually gives us all four. The one on the inside and some of the ones on the outside. So it extends the angle. You can imagine the angle going forever in all directions here. And it actually gives us all the angle bisectors here. So if you were to extend line AB, let's do that. We're going to make a line that's AB, so we extend AB. And we'll also extend CA. And now what you have are four angle bisectors. So you get all four of them with one command. Edit, we'll clear all. Next, we have parallels. So let's draw a line. Let's make a point. All right, let's grab our selection tool. Select line AB, point C, and we'll draw parallels. There's your parallel lines. Again, let's try moving some things around and see if that actually stays. So we'll tap and hold B, tap B, release, tap and hold, move it. And now you notice, no matter what I do, I can't get those two to intersect because these two are in fact parallel. Let's clear all again. Next on the line we have tangent, so we can make a point of tangency. Same thing, you need yourself a basic construction, so we have a circle, center and radius. I'm going to place a point on the circle. To place a point on the circle, grab your point tool, select a point on the circle, just tap the circle, and there you have it. Grab the selection tool, point C, circle A, tangent, through C. There we have it. Edit, clear all. Let's construct a reflection here this time. This time let's start out with a line segment, AB. And we'll put a point C out here, not on AB. We want to reflect point C across AB. So let's pull up the reflection tool. I want to reflect point C. It's going to be reflected across AB. Notice I have C prime and it comes out in green. Grab the selection tool, tap on C, tap and hold C and move it. Watch your reflection change. Tap A, tap and hold, move A. Notice your reflection changes. We'll go ahead and edit and clear all. We have a few more to try here. Let's try a dilation. Let's start out with a construction here. Let's start out with just a regular triangle. We'll select the triangle. Select a vector. We'll type in a vector. Let's go with vector 2 and 0.5. We'll say OK. Now it's been translated over by a vector of 2 and 0.5. You also could have drawn in a vector. So if we draw in a vector that we would like to use as our reflecting vector, we would like to reflect this figure across using the vector R. So we'll select the triangle, all three sides. We'll go to reflect. We'll select the vector this time. Select that vector, and there you have it. So you could either have a vector to start with or reflect it according to some vector coordinates. And now if I tap and drag the vector, I get my construction moving around the anywhere my vector goes, so goes my reflection. We'll go ahead and clear all. Next we have a rotation. Again, let's start out with something to rotate. Let's select three sides, 1, 2, and 3. Let's go rotate across an angle of 90 degrees. Okay. I tapped on the screen to give me my center of rotation, which was D, and then it asks me for my angle of rotation. If I come and grab D and then move it, the whole construction moves. Or I can actually try A prime. Notice what happens that time. When you move the reflection, it actually moves the original parent. So if I want to move the parent, the reflection moves, or you could move the reflection and watch the original change. Or grab your point of rotation and move your point of rotation. Again, let's go ahead and clear all there. We're going to try dilation. Again, let's start out with a triangle here. We'll go and select all three sides, 1, 2, and 3. Let's go ahead and make a dilation here. Again, we're going to start it with a center. I placed a center, dilation of 1/2. So I tapped point D. It wouldn't show up until after you tell it what you want to do. So I want to do a dilation by 1/2. Tap and hold D and move it. Everything moves. Just tap D. Everything was selected originally. Now you're just moving D. Let's move point C prime and see what happens. The child moves, so does the parent. If we move the parent B, the child will move also. Lastly, we have something that looks like a matrix. What this actually does is it rotates and translates. So you can do a rotation and a translation. So we start out with a triangle and select our rotation scale or translation. You can do one, both, or one of each. You can either do rotation or scaling or translating or do a little of both. Let's try this. And we'll put in just a couple of numbers here. Okay. Let's do the same thing, only this time we'll try a translation by 5 and -2. Or you can do a little bit of both. We'll select all three sides again, and let's do both. Let's do 1, 2, 3, and 4. As a rotation or scaling, and we'll do 1/2 and 2. And we'll tap OK. And now we got a third one. So you can do a combination of one, both of them, or a combination with both of them together. So either rotation, scaling, or do them both. Let's go ahead and clear all, get rid of all this. So there you have it. That's just the basics on some basic construction tools. Next geometry video, we're going to get more into detail on how you can do measurements and making tables and animations.